In some other news, mental health experts have tasked government to reopen mental health clinics, which have been turned into COVID-19 centers. The experts revealed that this should be done urgently at district and regional referral facilities for persons with psychological and intellectual disabilities to access health services.
Speaking to the media at their offices in Lunguja, the Executive Director, Mental Health Uganda, Derek Chiza, noted that while the country is gearing towards recovery, the measures taken in the fight against the COVID-19 seem to be permanent, as ICU infrastructures that have been set up in mental health facilities like Hoima, Moroto, have led to death of mental health patients.
The long-term impact of COVID is going to be extremely severe. We might not establish it now, but the impact of COVID on mental health is going to have very severe consequences in the long term.
Chiza also asked government for increased funding so as to reduce on the number of mental health patients, as many have been affected psychologically due to the pandemic. The executive director, Mental Health Recovery Initiative, Benon Kabale, said after lifting the lockdown, there has been reported increase in new cases of mental illness and relapses from the patients that were already on medication.
Living with mental health challenges, we are faced with a lot of difficulties in handling and managing the illness, given the fact that there was a total ban on transport means to hospital settings where they are required to go.
Butabika Hospital alone registered over 1,680 new cases after lockdown in July.
All regional referral hospitals were given tents that in the event that we have so many cases, these people can actually be placed in tents.
A World Health Organization survey carried out in October 2020 found that critical funding gaps are halting and disrupting crucial mental health services in Africa as demand for these services rise amidst the COVID-19 pandemic. 37% of countries reported that their COVID-19 mental health response plans are partially funded, and a further 37 reported having no funds at all. Story compiled by Simon Semazi for the news in Kampala.